Little League World Series. The lower hill is full, and it will be tomorrow when Monet Davis and Philadelphia are on the field. They're the team that beat the boys from Nashville. They're back, hoping to score some runs tonight. Let's take a look at our starting lineup. It's brought to you by Kellogg's Frosted Flakes.
Hey, my name is Drew Byers, and my favorite player is Nomar Garciaparra.
My name is Tyler Finley, and my favorite player is Mike Trout.
My name is Ian Fry, and my favorite player is Mike Trout.
My name is Ryan Garcia, and my favorite player is Alcides Escobar.
My name is Tyler Hammonds, and my favorite baseball player is David Ortiz.
Hi, my name is Robert Hassel III, and my favorite baseball player is Freddie Freeman.
Hi, my name is Houston High, and my favorite baseball player is Caleb Joseph.
I'm Garrett Justice, and my favorite baseball player is Buster Posey.
My name is Blake Money, and my favorite player is Ben Zobrist.
Hi, my name is Cade Reynolds, and my favorite player is David Ortiz.
My name is Sam Slaughter, and my favorite baseball player is Yadier Molina.
I'm Barrett Smith, and my favorite player is Billy Hamilton.
Hi, my name is Essen Snyder, and my favorite baseball player is Clayton Kershaw.
And because someone identified Nomar, I'm Carl Ravitch, and my favorite baseball player is Barry Larkin.
Boy,
there you go.
Come on now.
Addison Kopach is on the mound, and you're getting a good look at him right there. Got to face a team that can put some runs on the board, and we'll see if it was Monet Davis or it was their offense or a combination of both that shut him out in the opener.
Well, Carl, I think just like in the games we've seen previous today, there's going to be a sense of urgency early in the game to try to score early. So look for these hitters to be aggressive.
Barrett Smith right off the leg of Kopach, and that was ripped up the middle. And we'll see if Kopach is okay. It didn't bounce before it hit that right leg of his. He's kind of limping around. That pain may develop as time goes on. Nick Proto comes over and says, dude, you all right? Now David Blau's going to go on out and check.
It isn't.
Saw Barrett Smith go over and ask how Addison was doing too.
Well, you can see right here that ball was ripped right up the middle, and it did not draw grass no more until after it hit him in that shin.
It was a good swing. He stayed on it.
That's the way you're taught, right, Barry? Drive it right back up the middle.
So hopefully it looks like he's okay. And it was also nice of Smith to kind of come over and check on him and kind of give him a fist pump and high five and ask if he was okay.
They told him also, make sure you throw that same pitch next time I'm up.
I like where that one was.
Yeah.
Robert Hassel is going to be the pitcher tonight for Nashville. Good start with a single. Off-speed pitch in the dirt. The coaches love Barrett Smith as leadoff guy. They're worried when they're in the third and first base boxes, and for good reason. We saw that one. It was a shot back off the pitcher. Kopach looking for his first strike since getting hit. Two and one. If there's been a knock on the Nashville kids from the coaches, it's just been a little lack of focus, and they believe that maybe some of that was there against Philadelphia, although they're quick to credit Monet and that team. They lost 13-0 to Virginia in the regionals and bounced back, so they weren't focused that night. There's a good off-speed pitch, 2-2. As Barry said, Nomar, in this situation, you're going to be focused because you lose the ability to win a championship if you lose tonight.
Yeah, and there's different ways to focus, and they said they're focused, yet they're loose. They seem to be a lot looser, not as uptight as it was their first game. And I think they were a little shell-shocked. And I also know that they were also competing against 20,000 fans that were all cheering for Pennsylvania.
There is a Monet Davis factor. They're going to play tomorrow night. She is not eligible to pitch. Ball four, so the first two men are on for Nashville and a good start.
Good start for Nashville. You get your first two guys, and also the guy coming up to the plate and Sam Slaughter. Him just introducing himself before the game, I was like, wow, I wouldn't want to throw to that guy.
Boom.
Right?
Great uncle, big country Eno Slaughter. That one got him on the foot. Now the bases are loaded, and you wonder if that ball off of the shin of Kopak is affecting his ability to pitch in the zone. Uh-oh, time already for Rhode Island, and that's why David Belisle's heading out to the mound to check on his pitcher.
Okay. All right, kid. I know they're juiced, right? But I know you can do this, okay? Let's limit the damage, all right? Gonna locate this kid. Kid's a good hitter, okay? You gotta pick your spots, all right? If he hits it high, let's hope he hits it on the ground, one of your infielders, and we might be able to get two. But let's get one at a time, one pitch at a time. Okay, look at me, okay? You can do this, all right? Don't worry. Is your leg okay? That's the most important. It's all right? Okay.
He wore a path out there last night, changing pitchers and giving speeches to try to get his players to be as positive as he is. And tough spot here. Barrett Smith, the single, a walk, a hit batter, and Blake Money, who was here last year, bat cleanup. Nobody out. One got him too with a hit batter, and a run's gonna come in. So a nightmarish start for Rhode Island and a very good start for Nashville, Tennessee.
Well, we talked about the fastball in trying to get inside the power of these hitters, and unfortunately that one's a little too far in.
Looks like we're going to get Houston High coming in as a special pinch runner for Blake Money. Not sure if you saw that, but Blake's got a couple of siblings. One of them is named Cash. So Cash Money.
Why wouldn't it be?
There you go. One of them is Cash. Who's hard earned and who's found? There's a whole host of. There's Cash.
There he is.
Out.
I wonder if Cash Money has a nickname. Change.
Robert Hassel's down there at third base. Sam Slaughter at second base. Blake Money was at first base. He's been replaced by Houston High. Good pitch. That's a foul ball, according to the umpire. Foul ball. I think he may have thought it hit the foot of Garrett Justice.
We saw Bork jump right out of his squat behind home plate and go for the ball, and he got it before and tagged, but he didn't have the ball in his glove, and we have another look here. And tell you what, that's a fair ball. I don't think that got his foot.
Maybe a break for Rhode Island because the run was coming in. Breaking ball had no break on it to stay loaded.
And Garrett Justice also had to move his bat out of the way on that one. One of those where you, you know, Barry, where you duck and it ends up hitting your bat behind you.
2-2. Good job to stay alive there. Justice off balance on that swing. The unpredictability of 12 and 13 year old boys. All of a sudden, we got nobody out. Pitcher that we've relied on all summer. Drilled a few kids. He got drilled. That's a good pitch. He's called out on strikes. Trey Bork didn't exactly frame it, but it got enough of the plate. It's the first out of the inning.
Fastball down and away.
Now
your thoughts.
Number 12.
Strike three. There we go.
There you go.
Cade Reynolds. He got right on the fists on that one.
You're Rhode Island. You can get out of here, as the manager said, and limit the damage. You got to certainly feel good about your chances.
Reynolds 0 for 2 against Monet Davis in Philadelphia. That one is going to go foul and into the seats. Well, if there weren't a screen there, it was going to go into the seats.
You're exactly right, Bear. I mean, early on, already in the first inning, you have a chance to really change some momentum here. The nine gets at it with just one run. I think the momentum shifts on their side, and Tennessee can capitalize on this. It really is a big blow.
Interesting, the pitcher, Addison Kopech, looked out at his left fielder, just told him to move back. He's outside, and it's 1-2. We're all familiar with Goodlettsville, Tennessee, a few years ago. This team played them in the district, beat them. That's an automatic sort of credibility builder because Goodlettsville is such a good program. Count 2-2 to Cade Reynolds in the top of the first of the elimination game. Now we're full. Looks like when he tries to throw it a little harder, tends to pull it a little bit. Three and two men down, back-to-back strikeouts for Addison Kopech.
Well, he gets the strikeout on Justice, the batter before, on a nice pitch down and away, and then he comes up and in on Reynolds to get him swinging. And just right before that pitch, he even shook off the pitch, and I think location to come back in there.
Drew Byers had one of the two hits off Monet Davis in the opener. There's a good pitch, a fastball in there for a strike at 69 miles an hour. So Addison Kopech settling in a little bit. He is living inside, and now it's 0-2. A chance to really get out of this with only one run across. And you have to think that would be huge. Strike three, so with the bases loaded, nobody out, he strikes out Garrett Justice, Cade Reynolds, and then Drew Byers. Whatever it is that David Belisle's able to get out of his keys, we got a chance to see it right there. 1-0 in favor of Nashville with Rhode Island coming up. Going to feel like they won the first inning by holding Tennessee to only one run. Rhode Island in the bottom of the first. They'll come to the plate now. Let's meet the kids from Cumberland.
Hi, my name is John Belisle. I play second base, and my favorite baseball player is Robinson Cano.
Hi, my name is Trey Bork, and my favorite baseball player is Hanley Ramirez.
Hi, my name is Nick Croteau. My favorite baseball player is Matt Rockefeller.
Hi, my name is CJ DeVoque, and my favorite player is Matt Rockefeller.
Hi, my name is Addison Kopech, and my favorite player is Matt Rockefeller.
My name is Mason Matos, and my favorite player is Mike Trout.
Hi, my name is Sean Mears, my favorite baseball player is Matt Rockefeller.
Hi, my name is Tyler Provost, and my favorite baseball player is Matt Rockefeller.
Hi, my name is Tyler Shaw, my favorite baseball player is Matt Rockefeller.
Hi, my name is Jaden Struble, my favorite player is Mike Trout.
Hi, my name is Trey Tebow, and my favorite player is Dustin Pedroia.
My name is Brendan Wright, and my favorite baseball player is Matt Rockefeller.
I keep mentioning Matt Rockefeller. He was a teammate and friend on some of the Little League teams. And just before this run started, he lost his life. So a lot of the players paying tribute to Matt Rockefeller. A lot of them have purple ties on their bags. That's why we heard the name Matt Rockefeller so often. Number nine is Robert Hassel. He's the pitcher tonight. Pretty good numbers if you like 18 Ks and 9 2/3, almost two an inning. Nick Croteau will lead things off. Third baseman, tough out at the top of the order. Lefty slings one in there for a strike.
Well, if you're Rhode Island, you have to once again feel great about that first half an inning that you got out. Yeah. Giving up just one run. So the momentum is still on your side.
Ball, strike two, tough pitch. Get the the impression tonight you better be up there and swing if it's close. He does. That one was almost over his head, and it's a strikeout. You guys have played enough baseball. When the umpire's given a big zone, does it change your approach a little bit?
Well, you better be up there swinging, that's for sure. You're not going to go out there and really look, say, okay, I'm going to try to work the walk or work the count. You're thinking, okay, if I get an opportunity, the first pitch that's close, I'm going to have to let it fly.
C.J. DeVoque. Called strike, good pitch.
Although I took that attitude every time I stepped into the plate.
I'm saying, this is not the guy you want to ask that question to, Carl. That's all I'm saying.
I didn't have to worry about it.
That's right.
CJ had a good night last night. 2 for 2, couple walks. He was on base 4 times. He swings and misses, and it's 0-2. I know, any patient question or did you like that hitter's count? Nomar hitter's count was 0-0.
Listen, I was patient. I patiently waited for the first pitch to be thrown.
That's right, man. That's an attitude. Why you mask.
Two straight strikeouts. Robert Hassel looking very comfortable to start this game. Always something about a left-handed pitcher, just look smooth.
Nice breaking ball right there. Good downward plank.
Mixing up his pitches. His first breaking ball almost hit Croteau. And then now it seems like he's found that.
The J-Dog, Jaden Struble, had some chances last night with men on, and that was their story and their loss. Couldn't deliver. Big hack at that one to even account 1-1. On the ground to short. Drew Byers crossed the diamond. Good speed from Struble, but he's out by half a step. 10-pitch inning, and team from the southeast, Nashville, Tennessee, up 1-0, trying to get some more base runners here. Welcome back. Dave Belisle saw his team send only 3 men to the plate, very different than the top half of the first when Nashville sent 7 to the plate, but they were able to get out of it after 3 straight strikeouts, and here's what it sounded like when the inning ended.
Yeah!
Yes, sir!
That's my
David Belisle comes from a family of coaches. His dad, one of the most successful, if not the most successful, high school hockey coach in the state of Rhode Island. A lot of these kids here play hockey. It's in his blood. It's something he loves to do. And this is the second time he's taken a Cumberland, Rhode Island team to the Little League World Series. They were here back in 2011.
Carl, you get a coach that is that enthusiastic about your success, it makes you want to do even better. There really is something in correlation to a guy that is that positive.
Ryan Garcia up the middle. It was stopped. Throw to first. No, not in time. Really good effort out there by the second baseman, but to no avail. It's John Belisle out there. Diving stop.
John Belisle comes up with the play right there. You see, couldn't quite find the handle. Throwing from the knees.
Good hustle by Garcia getting down the line.
Single for Garcia. Possible bunt situation here for the number 9 hitter. Eston Snyder in a nice defensive play in that game against Philadelphia. 4-8, 75, and they call him the Big E. Love that. Squared to bunt, called strike as he pulled back. Big E, 75.
75 large.
Cash money. Ball strike 2.
1-2.
1,826 miles to get to the Little League World Series, so where did he come from? This ball to right. Nice catch out there by Sean Mears. Aston Snider got into that one, all 75. And he gave it a ride. We now know that it's Memphis, Texas. So if you live in Memphis, Texas, and you're thinking about how many tanks of gas you need, now you know exactly how many miles. Back to the top, Barrett Smith. Number 15 lined a shot off the right leg of Austin Kopac to start this game.
Yeah, he didn't start him off with that same fastball. He kind of took something off it. If you're going to hit it, pull it, please.
Out of play off the end of the bat. A couple of off-speed pitches and ahead 0-2. Tried to bring a fastball, and he just got it by him enough that he would hit that into foul territory. These guys, it is really something you can tell how conditioned they are to hitting a fastball.
Yes.
Every team.
Yes. It's those pitchers that can change it up, take a little of the pace off the ball that have shown success so far in this tournament. Oh.
Trey Bourque was trying to look back the runner at first base, Brian Garcia. But Trey Bourque's about 4'9", and Barrett Smith's about 5'3", so he was like a wall. He couldn't get around him. On the ground, they'll throw to second, get one. No play to first, but a nice job by Addison Kopac, and C.J. DeVoe is covering to cut down the lead runner. Music City, of course, is Nashville, Tennessee. Luke Bryant gave a shout out to this team. 609,000 and growing. Second consecutive Little League World Series appearance for the South Nashville Little Leaguers. R.A. Dickey, the great Sonny Gray of Vanderbilt, David Price, all Nashville natives. One of the coaches on this team, Grant Martin, Ryan Mullins. It was Mullins who pitched at Vanderbilt. He spent about 7 years in AA and AAA in the minors. On the ground, a second tough play there as Belisle just didn't get down and stay down on it. Runner going into second. Out at second base. Sean Mears came over and threw in. And the throw was to the left side of the bag, but DeVoe appeared as if he made the tag. We'll take a look at it. They'll discuss whether they want to review it or not. Looks like he got him on the foot before the foot touched the bag. Nomar says no. Come right back and find out. Welcome back, everyone. Williamsport, Pennsylvania. And they did look at that play at second base. C.J. DeVoe putting a tag on Robert Hassel. Let's take a look at it. You guys at home can kind of be your own judge. That is just so close.
That is close.
Well, you notice that runner slides to the outside side of second base. If he simply makes an adjustment for you watching at home, if that throw is coming from the outfield, think about sliding to the inside part of the bag away from the defender.
Call stands. Base runner out. Really good play by DeVoe to get the ball and dive as the throw came in from the outfield to the left side. Take a look at the fun times in Williamsport brought to you by Kellogg's Frosted Flakes.
Hi, my name is Essence Snyder and my favorite baseball player is Clayton Kershaw. Go Southeast.
Do you have any mottos?
No, not really. Well, yeah, go Southeast.
What's 7 times 3?
21. Go Southeast. Go Southeast. Go Southeast. Go Southeast. Go Southeast. Go Southeast. Go Southeast.
One more in the hallway. Loud.
Got spiders flying. He does deserve a hot dog with all sorts of things on it, too. Oh, you're gonna have that one?
Spread the word. Walk over to the ketchup and mustard.
Did you get yours, Carl?
No, I had a good one. Just a little ketchup. That thing's got all sorts of condiments on the top of it. There's Southeast. Eston Snyder. I think that's his new nickname, Southeast. You don't have to spend a lot of money at the Little League World Series to have a great time. There are no tickets that cost anything. The parking's free. 2 1/4 gets you dog. Fries more expensive. Popular item. And we begin play with Robert Hassel, who's doing his best Monet Davis imitation. He looks very smooth mechanically. Addison Kopach. Monet's just checking what number the Twitter followers have now. It's now 1,000,006. There they are, the team from the Taney Little League in Philadelphia.
So the catcher, Slaughter, just asking, say, hey, can you see if he happened to check swing? Home plate umpire doesn't want to ask.
Here comes the 1-2. Fouled out of play. Hassel's pouring strikes in the strike zone. 15 pitches, 11 have been strikes. There's another one. Remember, this was the team last year, Nomar, when you were here. Their travel to Williamsport was a nightmare. They had all sorts of delays, and they had no luggage when they got here.
Sorry, was it the team from Australia that really helped them out and said, hey, yep, you can practice with our equipment?
Exactly. Breaking ball just didn't get any part of the plate. The team that last year finished the tournament around 9:30 on a Friday night. They had to get on a bus at 2. There's a strikeout. Went to Atlanta for a flight at 6:15 a.m. and they ended up landing in Philadelphia because their plane had mechanical issues. Then they drove to Williamsport, got in at 10:30.
Wow.
So 9:30 one night, 25 hours later, they got to where they had to go, and they were going from Tennessee to Pennsylvania. We had a flight canceled from Hartford to LA. We just drove to New York, Barry. Remember that trip?
Yes, I do.
A lot easier than what those kids dealt with last year. Tyler Provost, 1-1.
See, when I see Hassel on the mound and he lets that fastball go, I know it's not registering. We don't show it unless it's like 70 miles an hour or higher, but it looks that way. It gets on the hitter quickly.
There's a hit into right field, hit sharply. And Tyler Provost is aboard. First hit and base runner for Rhode Island. They started slowly last night, as Barry said at the top. Then they began to hit, especially late.
It was a good job by Provost getting on top of that ball, top of that fastball, and driving it to a right field.
Sean Mears. That one hard on the ground, short, and underneath the glove of the shortstop. Almost looked like it got there quicker than Drew Byers would have thought. But I defer to the two great shortstops sitting next to me. Is that what happened?
Yeah, that got on him really quick there. He didn't even get the glove down in time. It wasn't like you misplayed it. You just wasn't quick enough with his hands.
Right, didn't have enough time to react. You see right here, ball's hit a little bit to his left. By the time he takes a step over and goes down to catch it with two hands, too late. There's a bullet.
So we'll see if they can do a little more damage with men in scoring position than they did last night. Called the ball. Looked like Trey Burke thought about offering at it. They'll check the first base umpire, who says no, he didn't. One out. Rhode Island's first rally here in the second inning. That one in the dirt. It's called a ball. They're going to appeal one more time. Same call. Trey Bork's the catcher for Rhode Island. And a hit 3-1. A couple of hard hit balls, and all of a sudden the game feels a little different right now for Cumberland. This one to center field, and it's deep. And it's gone! A three-run home run for Trey Bork. Three hard hit balls in the inning for Cumberland, Rhode Island. It started with Provost and then Mears, and now Bork launches one.
Well, fastball up out over the plate. Once again, Trey Bork gets his arms extended. And we talked about that 225. There's not home, these young fellas.
We also mentioned how they can catch up to some fastballs. Everybody here, they're used to seeing the velocity now, but they're missing the location at any level, right? Can cost you.
I know we've had that discussion about you never swing down in the ball, but my goodness, Trey Bork looked like he swung down on that and elevated it. Belial swings and misses. So where Rhode Island has been, they'll get them in bunches, and then they'll go quiet for a while.
The case last night wasn't necessarily getting runners on base. They were actually hit 341, 9 for 26. It's just when they get those runners in scoring position, they were able to come through right there.
You want to hit it, John!
There's James, John at the plate. David down at third base. Takes a good hack at it and fouls it back. Manager's just almost willing his son to get a hit here. James was on that team back in 2011.
2-2. Play.
Slow roller to first. And Blau's going to be retired before he gets there. Here's another home run hitter. Mason Matos, you talk about feast or famine. He's got just a couple of hits when you think about the regionals and the World Series, and both of them are home runs. That's it. Average and a home run. Nice pitch there as Robert Hassel took a little bit off of it. Now 1-2.
1-2.
Look out. Slung it behind him.
Looked like he wanted to get a little extra on that fastball there.
Usually lefties will throw behind the back of a left-handed hitter, not a right-handed hitter.
Well, a little different today. Getting some hits with runners in scoring position. Trey Bork able to get on top of that high fastball. That's called the tomahawk. Take that.
Superstars, day three, nearly completed Little League World Series. As we take a look at our Fresh Take, it is brought to you from Williamsport by Subway and by Monet Davis and the team from Philadelphia having a blast. Good to see 12 and 13-year-olds enjoying themselves. Pierce Jones had a huge day. We look forward to seeing Chicago and Las Vegas tomorrow. 2 Eastern on ABC, should be a dynamite game. Monet Davis and Philadelphia take on Pearland, Texas, and Takuma Takahashi's really had the most dominant performance, overshadowed by Monet, but 14 strikeouts in 6 innings. Gave up 1 hit. And those are the 3 stars so far, with much more time and games to be played. They reserve the top rows for the players. It's not just Philadelphia kids up there. Some players from South Korea up there as well. The Northwest was up there. We had a good one, 3-1. We're going to the top of the third, Rhode Island and Tennessee. This is little country. Big country was his great-great uncle, Eno Slaughter. So Sam Slaughter, we're gonna go little country, but he's a big kid. And he can do that. Sam Slaughter's left the building. It is 3-2 with a huge home run the other way.
Atta boy, get him up! Get him up!
I don't know if you can call him little country.
Not anymore.
Not hitting the ball opposite barrel with that kind of distance. Maybe you can call him big country junior.
There you go.
Because my, oh my, what a swing. Another ball out over the plate. Sam Slaughter gets his arms extended, and he knew right away. 225. You better put those fences back.
No, look at that. There's the second fence over there, too. That couldn't even hold him either.
Goodness.
He is strong, Sam Slaughter, and he carried them during the regional tournament. He hit 533 with 3 homers, so there's his first here in Williamsport. Called strike to Blake Money, who looks down to his third base coach as if pleading with him to help. Two at 2. Nope, 3-2. At the regionals, these 3, Slaughter, Hassel, and Blake Money, 18 hits, 15 runs in 5 games. They dominated. And now a 3-2 pitch. And a walk, ball 4 to Money. Talked a little bit about tomorrow's schedule. We'll start at noon Eastern time, ESPN2 for South Korea, who looks great. They'll take on Puerto Rico. These are all teams at 1. And then Las Vegas and Chicago, 2 Eastern ABC. Join us for that one as well. 5 o'clock Eastern time, Mexico and Japan, which always is an entertaining game. And then at night, the team from Pearland, Texas, gets Monet Davis and the Taney Dragons out of Philadelphia. Monet will likely be at first base. She will not be eligible to pitch. Tough pitch to bunt there from Ian Fry, and he fouls it back.
I don't think if Ian Fry doesn't make contact with the ball, that might have hit him.
The defensive changes for the team for Rhode Island. Tyler Shaw is at third base. Nick Kroto's moved over to second base. Brendan Wright's in left field now. Provost in center. Trey Tebow is in right field. Trey had a good night last night, and he got to pitch late in that game. Left with a big smile on his face. What a job. But the home run hitter Trey Bork gave you all of his frame to go get that one.
He was asking for that pitch up. I don't think he was asking for it that high.
by going, he's gone. Fourth strikeout of the game for Addison Kopac, and it was a big one with a man on first. Cade Reynolds struck out in the first. He was part of that back-to-back strikeouts with the bases loaded that Kopac was able to get. That one missed inside.
See, Boric, he's been trying to go inside and then going way off the plate. And why wouldn't he? He's been getting a call off the plate.
Ball. Notice how quickly Boric is catching it. And then he's flexing his hand because the ball's coming pretty hard. He doesn't want that runner at first to get any ideas. Good fastball. It's now 2-2. Off-speed pitch gets him. And the second strikeout of the inning, fifth strikeout of the game.
It's a good job by Kopac here, just taking something off of it on the outer half. I mean, that catches the corner and also gets him out in front and a swing and a miss.
His left hand is killing him. Fastball, there's not enough padding in that glove anymore. Houston High pinch hitting. Every time takes that glove off. We got to get another glove on his catching hand.
Got to get him some pads down there. Yeah, something.
Late on that fastball. Borky's a tough kid behind home plate. Plays hockey, wears number 77, of course, in honor of Ray Bourque, who used to play for the Bruins. Love the nickname for Houston High. High five.
Yeah, Durian didn't get to pick his number here, but he usually wears number 5 because that's what he likes to see on his back. That says high five.
Love it. 1-2, two out pitch, off speed in the dirt. Unable to hang on to it, is Bourque behind home and he'll stay alive. Houston High. Misses with the off-speed pitch. It's a consistent miss. He's always in the left-hander's batter's box with it.
You drill it, okay? Give me a gapper right here. Here we go. Attaboy.
Chris Mercado's the coach. He's made a life mission, really, of making sure that the little leaguers in Nashville have great fields to play on. He's been responsible for the development of the fields and the program. Fastball, called strike 3. Half dozen strikeouts, and Rhode Island's halfway home, leading 3-2.
Well, the big man, Sam Slaughter, showing off the power, going the other way over the second fence.
Attaboy, get him up! Get him up!
We're back, everyone. Earlier today, you're looking inside the Oakland A's clubhouse. They'll be on Sunday Night Baseball. They're battling in a series with the Atlanta Braves. And Sunday night, John Lester's going to be on the mound for Oakland, and Atlanta will counter with Julio Teheran. It's been a very good series, and both of these teams trying desperately to get into the postseason right now. Sonny Gray, the native of Nashville, behind 2-0 to Atlanta. They're in the bottom of the third inning in Atlanta. So you go Gray and then Lester, and that's why Oakland has been able to continue to win. Ground ball through the hole, and a good start to the inning. That's Nick Proto delivering, the leadoff hitter for Rhode Island.
Major League Baseball players are watching, as are general managers, as are agents.
So we're scouting. We're already on 12 and 13 year olds, right?
Oh yes,
absolutely.
I got a couple calls already on Pierce Jones.
Who's representing that kid?
Did you say I am? I will. I got it. CJ DeVoke. That's a really good pitch. Called it on a check. It looked like a strike to begin with. Count goes to 1-1.
And Nomar, to your point right there, you see the good changeup. If you can throw a changeup in this league with some downward motion on it, you're going to have a plenty of success, because that fastball right there, they're on it.
Right field, wind blowing in. Who's going to get it? Look out. The taller of the two players up there, Barrett Smith, stepped in front of Esten Snider and said, I got it. And they get the out.
Well, Smith was calling it right from the get-go, but Esten Snider's going, wait a minute, I'm the captain out here. I know you're taller than me, but I'm the captain. Now they're...
Now Jaden Struble. Ball one. Oof, good rip at it, fouls it back. Here's one of these guys, Nomar, that I can see challenging you to a ping pong match. He's already beaten kids from Australia and the Czech Republic.
That's fine.
Yep.
No, go over there and take all challenges. I'm not going to say I'm going to win, but I'll take them on.
Dunk tank it up for the loser. Jaden's got two twin brothers, Cameron and Dylan, who are both 4 years old. So there'll be a lot of Little League in the future in the Struble house.
1-2. Play.
Hey guys, one guy looks like he's jonesing for something to eat. He's like, I haven't had something in 4 minutes. We've got to get something going again. Struble swings and misses. Strikeout count climbs for Robert Hassel to 5. And now the opposing pitcher, Addison Kopach, trying to help himself here. Not sure the final score of this one's going to be 3-2 with the offense of both of these teams. Slow roll to third. Blake Money across the diamond for the out. They will strand one. And we are halfway through this one, the elimination game. Tennessee and Rhode Island, a one-run game.
Get him up right here.
The biggest thing was probably just learning how to compete from an early age in Little League. I think that kind of taught me how to get good at something. You got to work hard, you got to compete, and I think that carried me, you know, a long way through my life. It was just happening my turn in the rotation. You know, I knew I had to compete like crazy to keep up with these guys, and you know, I'd torn the cover off the ball all week. There was 50,000 people there screaming. I could certainly taste it, you know, being one out away. I thought I was gone, and our left field ended up camping under it right at the wall. And I think being on that stage in such a high-pressure situation, it certainly gave me a taste of how fun competing and winning is. fortunately, I was able to get on some more winning teams the rest of my career. And knowing that I started at the Little League field in Trumbull and a hockey rink in Bridgeport, you know, brings me great pride.
5-2, the team from Trumbull, Connecticut, able to beat the team from Chinese Taipei. And that ball that was hit there, it was a 5-2 final score. Remember, those fences were 20 feet closer than they are now. As we got a New England team on the field, not from Connecticut, though we've seen a lot of them with Westport and Fairfield the last 5 years. For 75 years, Little League has been strengthening communities and building friendships and providing great competition. It's the world's largest organized youth sports program with more than 2 million kids and 1 million volunteers making it all happen. And to learn more about the rich history, visit littleleaguebiglegacy.com. Team from the southeast now back up at it. Tyler Hammonds is going to pinch hit, lead things off in the top of the fourth. Six innings these games, part of this elimination game and bracket format that is the Little League World Series, with 16 teams, 8 on the United States side and 8 from the international side. Yeah. 2-0. Rapid City, South Dakota loses today to Lynnwood, Washington, and as a result, they've been eliminated from title contention, as has Canada and the Czech Republic. Lynnwood, Washington now begins that climb, so does Australia. Venezuela trying to come out of that loser's bracket, if you will, the teams that lose their first game. Chicago, Las Vegas play tomorrow at 2, Philadelphia and Texas tomorrow night at 7, with Mexico and Japan in action at 5 o'clock tomorrow. Special pinch runner Brian Garcia and a pinch hitter Tyler Finley. That last ball looked like it was a strike.
Looked pretty good to me.
Bunt back to the pitcher, who'll throw to second, and that is the out. They get the force there. Addison Kopach found CJ DeVoc. One man down.
Trying to get this down, just bunted it right back at the pitcher, and Kopach showing some good footwork there, getting off the mound and setting his feet so he can make a good throw to second base.
Top of the order, some thunder. Barrett Smith, Robert Hassel, Sam Slaughter for the Southeast.
Ball.
Barrett Smith, among the millions who enjoy watching Modern Family on ABC. Great, great show, funny show. Now the 1-0.
Ball.
Is it me or some of the balls that were called strikes early now being called balls?
No, it's not you.
It's not just me?
Nope.
All right, 2-0. There's a called strike on the corner outside, 2-1. Addison Kopach, 15 pitches away from having to come out of the game. He's thrown 70 so far. Tennessee with Smith and Hassel and Slaughter, money, one of the bigger teams that are here this year. It's ironic, Texas usually is a physically very big team. They're not that big this year, play very good baseball, but as far as sheer physical size, Tennessee may be the biggest of all of them, along with Chicago. This one's on the infield. The shortstop DeVoc is back in shallow left, and he makes the play. So with two men down, we ask what's at stake, and the winning team will play the loser of that game between Las Vegas and Chicago. That's the Monday, 8 o'clock Eastern time game. And regardless if it's Tennessee or Rhode Island, that will be a tough challenge. The losing team will be eliminated from title contention. We'll play a third game against an international team. Robert Hassel looks at ball one. Fastball on the ground to second. Proto makes most things look easy, and he did there. So through four innings, we get a one-run ball game. 3-2 in favor of Cumberland, Rhode Island, and we'll be back to Williamsport.
If you had touchscreen navigation, all-wheel control, and a rear-view camera, where would you take it? Wherever that would be, the 2015 Mitsubishi Outlander Sport will help you get there. Lease an Outlander Sport now for $199 a month.
I am Little League.
I am Little League.
Sportsmanship, teamwork, character. Little League, big dreams.
Leading some dancing on the Rhode Island sideline. Sprinkler going there as we take a look at our Honda game summary. It's been a good one. Tennessee's left six on base. Trey Bork hit a big three-run home run to center field in the second. And Addison Kopak, four innings, three hits, two earned, six Ks, has pitched a good game for Rhode Island. And by the same token, Robert Hassel has also pitched very well for Nashville. He's still on the mound. He's only thrown 58 pitches. Four-year-old twins out there.
So this dugout tired over there, getting carried. See that?
It's a long, long week, and we're only 3 days in. Tyler Provost to be followed by Sean Mears and Trey Bork, scheduled to hit here in the bottom of the fourth inning. 51 pitches. I think I said 58. That's his 51st. There's a good one in there for a called strike. Completely fooled.
Yeah, good pitch by Hassel there. Took something off of it. I'll tell you right now, for your Rhode Island, this is where they were able to score their three runs. Provost got on with a base hit.
Slaughter was ready to throw it down to third base. They've checked the appeal at first. I think Sam thought the ball was just a strike. Take a look at where the pitch was. Maybe a little low, but we've seen it called a strike tonight. Now a 3-2. Tyler Provost, 5'6", 123 pounds. His nickname of Mickey J came from a friend who called him Tyler McJiler, which became McJiler and then just shortened to Mickey J. Typical guy thing. Nice job by Hassel, and he dropped it, then he throws to first. Not in time. Boy, that first reaction was spectacular.
Yeah, but nice job by Tyler Provost, not giving up on the play, running hard, hitting the ball back to the pitcher. Still digging.
Yeah, very easy to give up and assume that you're out, but show with the quick hands with Hassel and then just drops it as he's trying to make the exchange.
Trey Tebow, they love to say Tebow time when he comes up. Had a good game last night, had a big hit, came on and pitched as well.
Hey, this Rhode Island team, this last time they scored, they capitalized on an error as well. So here they are, they get the leadoff runner on. With an error on the pitcher, see if they can do it again.
Trey Tebow left field and deep and gone! Trey Tebow having himself a Little League World Series to remember.
Watch it! Tebow died!
That is beautiful. He is 3 for 3 in the World Series, and look at the excitement from his mom there in the front row.
With Trey Tebow getting the fastball up in the zone, and he did not miss it at all. And this is what it's all about. Stand up, mama. Good boy, Trey. Make mama stand up.
Mom Rhonda is a nurse. What a moment for Trey Tebow. What a couple of games for Trey. And now it's a 5-2 lead for Rhode Island. The Trays have done damage tonight. Trey Tebow with a 2-run home run, and this guy, Trey Bork, with a 3-run home run. Foul ball. The 5-6-7 hitters, there's no more set at the top of the inning. 3 for 5 now, a couple of home runs, all 5 runs, 5 RBIs. Two and two, good battle here as Trey Bork avoids getting hit twice. That home run he hit earlier in the game was to straightaway center field. Ahead of that one, it's dropped, the catcher. Slaughter will throw it down to first for the out. One man down. After Bork strikes out, Tyler Shaw comes up. Fouled out of play. Not a bad role model to have if you're in that New England area. Quarterback of the Patriots made his first start of the preseason last night. Shaw swings and misses.
Michigan man.
He is a Michigan man.
Be the University of Michigan.
was going to say, he's from California.
Oh, okay. I just wanted to clarify that.
But a Wolverine. But a Wolverine.
Right. Absolutely.
We got a yellow jacket and a Wolverine and here in the booth.
With the same coach.
That's right, Danny Hall, Georgia Tech. Mm-hmm.
Barry was really coached by Bo Schembechler.
That is true. Told him that was the best football decision he's ever made, redshirting me and telling me just to play baseball. I appreciated that.
Worked out well for you, that's for sure.
Yes, it did.
Brendan Wright's going to get his first chance to take some swings.
Frozen ropes. I mean,
how you want them.
Good pitch. Broke in over the backside of the plate almost, and now 1-2 with 7 strikeouts, looking for his 8th. And the pitch from Robert Hassel. He's got it. But there was damage done that inning.
We call it Tebow time. Trent Tebow, the trains have done damage. Make mama stand up.
I like that. About to begin the 5th inning as Kellogg's Frosted Flakes presents the Little League World Series. We're here in Williamsport. A couple of home runs, 3 runs in the 2nd, 2 more in the 4th. But the 1st inning may very well be what decides this game.
Well, scoring opportunities come aplenty. During the game, you have to take advantage of them early in the game. Normar, first inning, bases loaded, but the guys were not able to push any runs across the board.
It seemed like Kopech all of a sudden settled down when the pressure was on, made the big pitches when he needed. We said, hey, this could be a momentum changer. And so far, the momentum has been all Rhode Island.
That could change, though, very quickly this inning with Sam Slaughter, Blake Money, Garrett Justice due up for the Southeast. Slaughter's got a home run. He blasted one to left over the hedges out there. This one is popped up and playable on the infield. Croteau calls it, and he's got it for 1 out.
Yeah, this is pretty big right now for Kopech, because if he can get Slaughter and Money, I mean, right now, this Tennessee offense, really the second half of this back half of this offense really hasn't done much this game. Needs to get past Money.
76 pitches, so he's got a total of 85 he can throw. He'd love to get through this inning. But that first inning telling, he had a bases loaded. He had allowed 1 run, and then he struck out in succession, Garrett Justice, Cade Reynolds, and Drew Byers. After, by the way, giving up a single, a walk, and 2 hit batters.
Yeah, that was a serious momentum change right there for Rhode Island. Rhode Island, at the end of the game last night, really started to put some runs on the board. And then they come out early in the game today, give up 1 run in the 1st, then the bases loaded. Then they got out of it. Big sigh of relief. Came out, scored some runs in the 2nd inning.
Blake Money's been on base twice. Once he was hit by a pitch, then he walked. Late on that fastball, and the count evens up 1-1. Ball.
coach.
Yep, third base coach over there begging for that one. Wanting that one to be fair, but right call, foul.
Stay back.
You see that catcher set up down and in. You better be ready down the third base line.
Yep.
Remember from 2001 to 2008, President Bush in the White House at that point used to hold those T-ball games on the lawn. Blake Money was at one of those, the last one, in fact. This one has popped up. Is it playable? Yes, nice job over there by Jaden Struble as he navigated the wall.
That was a fantastic play. Jaden Struble got to the wall and kind of walked up the wall. You want to get there. You don't want to drift to the wall. Look how he gets to the wall, finds the wall, and then he's able to come off the wall and make the play. That is a very, very good play. Great fundamentals.
Garrett Justice. Off-speed pitch is in there for a strike. Struble likely his last batter unless he can figure out a way to get Justice with his next three pitches, but he can finish this batter.
Four.
This game, we're getting towards the end of the game. Look at the reaction of each player. Every ball and strike and ball called, the players are out there reacting.
2-1, and Willie taking himself. Oh, he fires it to Croteau, who hangs on to it, and he's out. Some good sportsmanship right there. Good job by Garrett Justice. Question's going to be whose foot hit the bag first? See that Chris Mercado's kind of asking that same question. Take another look. For a second, I thought that Kopech was going to take it himself.
Yeah, which would have probably been a good idea there, but I think he's definitely out there. And Croteau's hanging
in there. The bulldog. The bulldog.
Yeah.
That's how I like it. That's how I want it.
He's mixed it up before, and
he wasn't worried about getting hit. He was like, I'm showing you the ball. I got it.
I just like the way Garrett Justice handled himself after that, too, by going right over to Croteau and shaking his hand.
Yes, nice job, man. Seen that a lot in the Little League World Series.
1-4. Top of the fifth is now over. Bottom five coming up. Rhode Island leading 5-2.
ESPN's coverage of the Little League World Series is presented by Kellogg's Frosted Flakes cereal. They're great. And in part by Pennzoil Platinum Full Synthetic Motor Oils with Pure Plus Technology. Motor Oil Reimagined.
That's going to go right in your glove.
Oh.
See that?
Great job.
Okay, now let's get ready for the ball. Here it comes. There you go.
Good catch. Perfect.
All right, now for the best part. Let's see your pour.
Ooh, let's get those in the bowl. These are way too good to waste, right?
Oh, yeah.
Let's go for it. Around the bowl. And
share what you love with who you love. Mm. Kellogg's Frosted Flakes.
They're great.
Good catch, Dad.
Pennzoil has reimagined a motor oil made from natural gas. Proven to keep pistons cleaner than any leading synthetic. Helping to protect against the loss of fuel economy. Designed for complete protection. Born from natural gas. Pennzoil Platinum with Pure Plus technology. Motor oil reimagined.
Oh, great. Can I get this too?
Yeah.
Footlong sweet onion chicken teriyaki.
Wait for it.
With the jalapenos and pepper jack cheese.
Toasted.
Five-tool phenom Mike Trout powers the long ball with his favorite, the Subway Sweet Onion Chicken Teriyaki, made the way he says.
Subway, longtime sponsor of Little League.
Legend. 2 Eastern on ABC. We'll see if the home run barrage continues for Chicago and if someone else can hit a home run. Austin Krizek, as athletic a player as there is in the tournament, will be on the field for Las Vegas, Nevada. That should be an outstanding game tomorrow, 2 o'clock Eastern time. We're looking forward to it. Good news for both those teams as winners. Neither will be eliminated tomorrow, so they know they'll have another meaningful game. In fact, both of them will. And here Rhode Island is trying to play themselves into another meaningful game as they lead it by a score of 5-2. 74 pitches in the game for Robert Hassel. So his night will end at some point here in the fifth, if not very early in the sixth, depending on the patience of the hitters for Rhode Island. And there will be a new pitcher for New England when the sixth inning begins as Kopech has thrown 85 pitches. Nick Crotto back up.
The ball is in the field.
He just got run over, but he's now in the batter's box, and he swings and misses at that. Shallow left. Playable and played well out there. Garrett Justice, that was the guy that ran into Crotto before that last inning just ended. USA Basketball National Team, the showcase. It's presented by Nike. It continues on ESPN. And we're getting close to tip there. 9 o'clock Eastern time, about 25 minutes from now. You'll be able to see James Harden, Derrick Rose, and what Mike Krzyzewski has had to do now that Kevin Durant is gone. And there have been some injuries as well. That's right after this game. It's also available live on Watch ESPN. Crotto retired CJ DeVoque. 0 for 2 tonight. Oh. Check swing, fair ball. Nice play by Hassel there as he flips to his first baseman, Cade Reynolds, and DeVoque is retired 0 for 3 tonight.
That was a nice play by both Reynolds and Hassel. Hassel getting off the mound, and then Reynolds recognizing how quick he got over there, so he didn't charge, so he stayed at first base. So this check swing, you see Reynolds, see why he comes in. Oh, he's got it, and you get back here, and we all right there?
Blown tire for DeVoque. Now Jaden Strubel. A slider that came across the plate at some point. 0-1. Ripped into right. That's a hit for Jaden Strubel. For New England, their fifth hit of the night. Special thanks going out to all the volunteers here in Williamsport, the millions who helped make Little League Baseball possible. They've been doing it for 75 years. Little League wants to extend its appreciation to the national sponsors, New Era Cap Company and Russell Athletic. And we would like to give a big shout out to all the volunteers here who helped make it comfortable for the ESPN team, and it is a large team. Grateful for all their support as well. From the president of Little League, Steve Keener, all the way to the volunteers that helped park the cars in the morning and security and whatnot. Addison Kopech, 1-0, 2-0. Coming, you just take so many things for granted that this runs so smoothly. It's a lot that goes into this. It's a stunner to me that all 16 teams can get here on time, given where they're all coming from, and the tournaments all play themselves out. 7,300 some odd teams begin it, and somehow you whittled it down to 16.
Oh, okay. That's why I call timeout?
Yeah.
Okay, kid. Hey, 3-0. He's at 85. He puts it down the pipe. Send it.
I think that means you've got the green light.
Yeah, yeah. Go. Five pitches means this will be the last batter that Robert Hassel can face. Saw Chris McCarter come out too. He's used his two challenges, so he's out of challenges as far as the replay goes. Struble at first, Kopac 3-0, green light. Swings and misses, 3-1. I'm a hitter, I'm told to go, and even if it's not in the zone, I want another chance. So I'm gonna swing anyway.
Fly.
Ball four, and that'll be the night for Robert Hassel as his pitch count and his limit has been reached. Were it not for the two home runs, it'd be a little different story, but he gave up a home run to Trey Bourque and a two-run shot to Trey Tebow.
Good job, baby, I'm proud of you. You need to go to center field, okay? Go to center field.
I got to
get that ball. Hey, guys, we got to believe that. We got to get out of this inning, okay? We got two outs.
Two on, two outs. Heard the words of the manager. We got to get out of this inning. A pitching change, and we'll be back to Williamsport.
Whether it's roaches in the vents or Indian meal moss in the pantry, I have everything from growth regulators to pheromone traps. They think they're going to get lucky, but their luck just ran out.
These cheesy bread dogs, the cheese is baked right into the bun.
It's what's on the outside that counts.
Huh, prove that.
Count on the cheesy goodness of the new cheesy bread dogs. This is how you Sonic.
Get us out of here, Donnie.
Grab a slice.
The 99 cheese pizza.
I don't even know what that is.
Of the summer's biggest adventure.
Please keep your arms and legs inside the shell at all times.
Ninja Turtles, rated PG-13.
At Goodyear, everything we've learned making these tires inspires what we roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven.
But you gotta be quick and get over that plate, big boy. Get over that plate. Yeah! Tebow, watch it. Tebow time.
My favorite moment of Little League World Series for sure is seeing Trey Tebow after a great debut last night. He goes yard tonight. The reaction of the whole team, his mom. What Little League Baseball is all about, and that smile will be painted on for a while. First pitch from the new pitcher, Tyler Finley, in there for a called strike. And Tyler Provost has reached base twice, once on a single, the other on an error. Chance to add to that lead with two men on. But he's behind 0-2. Finley, a very different pitcher, obviously a righty, and he throws some off-speed stuff.
1-2.
To get ahead. Knew the camera was on him. He masked up. That one just misses, and count goes to 2-2. Big inning last inning for Madison Kopac to get through Slaughter, Money, and Justice.
Yes!
He went. Inning over. So last ups for the team from the Southeast. Rally caps now on for the team from Nashville, trailing by 3.
Sitting in front of a camera all day is harder than it looks. So we bring in an expert to help us with our posture and delivery.
I want you to imagine a little string pulling your head up.
Where's the string?
You're holding a towel under your armpits. Eyes on the teleprompter. Mm-hmm. Don't look up to see the highlight. Mm-hmm. Look through the highlight.
You need a boatload of patience.
You know what? Forget everything I just said. Just be yourself. How's that feel?
Feels pretty good.
The football that we plan to bring is going to be an exciting brand of football. When the fans see the team fight for four quarters, the energy is going to be better in the stadium. You're going to get a chance to have a dynamic tailgating experience. You're going to be a part of the best show in town.
The Huskies kick off the season under new head coach Bob Diaco versus BYU on Friday, August 29th at 7. Single game tickets for BYU and all games are on sale now at UConnTickets.com.
Looks like the Garcias got a new car.
What'd they get?
I don't know.
Sure doesn't look like a Buick.
Buick.
I'm outside. Where are you?
I'm right here. I'm in the Buick.
I don't see a Buick.
Take a fresh look at Buick. It just might surprise you.
Ooh, that's not a Buick.
That's what I told him.
Wow. This is nice. Oh, my.
Lease select 2014 Buick Verano models in stock the longest for around $179 per month. But hurry. Get the best of remaining 2014s before they're gone.
Okay, we're just going to set this mic real quick.
Yep.
Okay, go for it.
Matthew Hegarty, my favorite player.
Riley, my favorite baseball player. Matthew Mugdali.
One of the things that all these kids have to deal with, the interviews from ESPN. It's the Little League World Series. It's presented by Kellogg's Frosted Flakes. And because it's part of a long day, the idea is to have a lot of fun in there, and they do. Some great smiles from the boys and girls here in 2014. And who'll be smiling when this one is over? Cade Reynolds, Drew Byers, and Brian Garcia due up for Tennessee as they have three outs to try to make something happen against the new pitcher, C.J. Devoc. Moves over from shortstop. Nick Croteau, who's been all over the infield, now is at shortstop. Kopak, the pitcher, to third base. Tyler Shaw is at second. Every night, it seems like the last three outs are a big challenge. We'll see if that's the case tonight.
Tell you, for Tennessee, they were 0-for-3 of runners in scoring position in that first inning. Since then, they hadn't had a runner in scoring position.
Oh, and two.
Talk about those scoring opportunities, and you're right, Omar, in that first inning. They did score the first run, but they had the bases loaded and three strikeouts. Two of them looking. The bases loaded.
0-2 to Cade Reynolds. Breaking ball, no. Close. Slow, slower, and slowest, and he gets a strikeout. And one man down here in the sixth inning. All right, Nomar, give us the backstory on Scott Byers, Nomar Garciaparra.
Well, Scotty was the first baseman at Georgia Tech when we were there. We ended up going to the College World Series together. There's Scott and Drew coming up. So there I am with Drew back in 2002, and then at the College World Series over there in 2010.
So the Byers family, like the Garciaparra family, big into World Series.
Yeah.
Little League, college.
His dad, Scott, had a good career at Georgia Tech and then played a little minor league ball with the Angel organization. It's good to catch up with Drew before the game. Good to see him.
Very cool, considering he was like two in 2002 and you got a chance to hold him then.
Yeah.
Really neat.
I'll tell you what, right now, they're going to need Drew to get on if they want to stay alive here.
It holds up for him, and he's on base. So Drew Byers gets a big hit here. Keep the inning alive with a single into right field. Smart by Sean Mears not to take the risk to go get it and allow Byers, if it were to get by him, to go to second and or third base. Because for a while, it looked like he thought about it.
It's a good bit of hitting. A little breaking ball from a right-handed hitter, a right-handed pitcher. The right-handed hitter just stays inside of it and drills the ball to right center field or right field.
Another base runner. Guys will bring the tying run to the plate. One man out, sixth inning, Brian Garcia. First pitch strike. Back in 2011, the team from Cumberland 1-2 in their World Series experience. On the corner, strike two to Brian Garcia.
And I'll tell you, DeVoe has come in throwing strikes. And that's what you need in this situation. You have a three-run lead. You don't want to give him any free passes.
And mixing up his pitches as well.
Good job at hitting. It goes into right field. Two men are on. And there's only one man out. And here we go again in the sixth inning. I want to remind everybody, this is a 75-year anniversary of Little League, who have been part of communities for three quarters of a century. The world's largest organized youth sports program with over 2 million kids and 1 million volunteers. LittleLeagueBigLegacy.com for more information. Tyler Finley will hit in the number 9 spot. Then it's the top of the order. Fastball called strike. To tie it with one swing.
He was going for it.
I mean, that wasn't a swing, just say, hey, I just want to get on base and keep this going.
That's changed the score swing right there.
Drew Byers at second, Garcia at first, 0-2. 1-2. Everyone on edge. Loser is eliminated tonight. On the ground, Struble with his backhand gets the second out.
A nice play by Struble over there. So you saw that ball was hit well, and there you and I, the infielders, know here comes that hop, that in-between hop, and look how he stays with that. Doesn't matter if you look at it. You know your gloves there. You turn the head a little bit.
You can't say that. We know that, but you can't say that.
And now Barrett Smith, with the losing team being eliminated and the winner playing the loser of the game between Chicago and Nevada tomorrow. Off-speed pitch. This is clearly somebody that can hit a home run. The leadoff hitter hits it as hard as anybody on the team. We saw that the first at bat when he shot one back up the middle off the leg of the pitcher.
Yeah, I've seen his last, after that first one, he lined off that fastball in the last couple of at bats. He's been out in front on a lot of off-speed pitches. Been unable to stay back on those.
Two men on, tying run at the plate. Down 2-1. Robert Hassel on deck. Will he get a chance? Barrett Smith, the leadoff hitter. Over the head of the third baseman. One run comes in. Rounding third is Garcia. He's in as the ball goes over the head of the catcher. And Smith down to second. It's a one-run game, and the tying run's on second base. A little bleeder off the bat of Barrett Smith.
Well, you called it. It was a bleeder right off the end of the bat. Barrett Smith just gets it into left field. Nick Croteau right here, throwing the ball off the backstop. Just think about keeping that runner at first base.
Yes, and that allowed Smith to get the second there. Now you have the tying run in scoring position.
Behind you, I'm with you on this all the way. Yeah. Okay, take deep breaths, okay? You still got the hammer, so go for it, okay? Hey, locate well over here. Nicholas, let's go. We're going to get it now. Let's go. Get the out. Forget about it.
Forget about it, huh? Love it. Love it.
Still got the hammer means you still got the lead, but it is tenuous at best, 5-4. And Robert Hassel. number two hitter in the order and one of the power hitters for Nashville. First pitch strike. One more out, Rhode Island will win and Nashville will be eliminated. Fastball, he chased it high and it's 0-2. Both sides now on their feet, Rhode Island's fans and Nashville's fans.
I want to see how outside Bork sets up for this pitch.
Wants it up. He got it up, and a good job by Robert Hasselnot to chase it. May do the same thing again. Three hits in the inning for Tennessee. They had three in the first five. This ball is driven and it is a Nashville lead. Robert Hassel, two-run home run, 6-5 in the sixth.
Well, you get a ball up in the zone, and that's what it is. But it's not the fastball. It's a hanging breaking ball. Robert Hassel did not miss it. You see the home run.
He stayed on that ball, head on the ball, line drive right center. And here's another guy who can hit him out.
Sam Slaughter already has a home run. Ooh, swings and misses at that. How about the two-out magic, though, from Robert Hassel.
He was down 0-2.
Yep. This ball driven to left field. It's gone. Second home run of the night. And back-to-back shots for Nashville give them a two-run cushion.
Good job, baby.
Just a smash from Sam Slaughter.
Well, this is what we've become accustomed to seeing from Tennessee and the regionals. You can see right there Sam Slaughter going to celebrate with his coach and loses his footing right there. But this is a quick strike team. And the big guys in the middle of the lineup have stepped up in this sixth inning.
The good things, okay? They just hit the ball hard, and there's nothing you can do about that. Okay? I'm proud of you, okay? Just finish this inning, and we'll go do our thing, okay?
Yeah.
Look at me, okay? I'm proud of you, okay, buddy? Keep fighting for me. CJ, I'm with you.
Words of inspiration, great stuff there. Check out Nashville's hitting tonight. Sixth inning, they're 5-for-7. In the first five innings, they were 3-for-18. And remember, this inning started with the number six hitter. Cade Reynolds struck out back-to-back singles. And then the number nine hitter went down. There were two outs, a double, and two home runs later. It's 7-5 Tennessee. The last three outs of Little League games are so difficult to record, especially quickly.
Girl, I'm not going to say Little League. I'm going to say last outs of any league.
This ball is to left field off the bat of Money. It's off the glove of the left fielder, right. Blake Money to second base. How about double, home run, double.
Well, we talked about it earlier. Your back is against the wall. Have a tendency to be a little more exact about it. And you can see right there, Blake Money hits the ball hard. Left fielder can't quite get there.
We also talked about backs against the wall. You need experience to help you through it. And the two guys with experience, you got Hassel coming up with that huge home run.
And now Blake Money fantastic. With a double here.
That's all I gotta say about you. It's fantastic. For you to stand out here, okay? Okay, for your teammates and do what you just did, okay? I'm very proud of you, okay? You be proud of yourself, too. You understand that? Okay, what we're gonna do is we're gonna take Tebow, crazy Tebow, because he can handle this craziness. We're gonna put you back in the position I love you playing, that shortstop, okay? All right? And I'm gonna take Mears out of the game. Okay, you got that, Ken? Can you handle us? Okay. Sean! Sean!
So it's Tebow time again. He, of course, had that big home run, which put his team up 5-2, but five runs in the sixth inning for Tennessee. And once again, just the lessons that David Belisle can teach all of us about respect to the game and the children and the other team, too. I think that's the most important thing is he always gives credit to the other team for, hey, they're hitting the ball hard. We're in the middle of this. We're loving it. He is an inspiration to listen to.
He always tells them how proud he is of every single one of them. He's like, he goes, you know how proud I am of what you've been out here taking the ball. You know how your team, what you've done for your teammates. It puts it
in perspective. And that's fantastic. And he's got lots of reasons to keep things in perspective. Four boys, a wife at home who's fighting cancer. Twice here, 2011, 2014, he's lived out a dream that so many Little League coaches across the globe wish that they could do, which is to get to Williamsport and participate in an event like this. A Team USA basketball game, which was scheduled to start at 9 right here on ESPN, is now moved over to ESPN News, and we'll pick that action up as soon as we're concluded here. Rhode Island will obviously bat in the bottom of the sixth inning. How about the thunder off the bats of the Nashville, Tennessee team, though? Barrett Smith actually was a single and then went to second on the throw. So this inning, we've had three singles, a double, and two home runs.
And we've had five runs scored so far in the first 11 innings this team has played here in Williamsport. Two runs.
On the ground, it gets past the shortstop. Being waved in from third. Here's your throw, and Tebow cuts it off. Garrett Justice reaches base with another hit. And believe it or not, we're back to the batter who started this inning off with a strikeout. That's Cade Reynolds. Seven hits in the inning. And we talk about the last three outs. Well, now it's going to be incumbent on Nashville to get the last three outs. Tomorrow, Chicago and Nevada, the loser will play the winner of this game. On the ground to third. Long throw across from Tyler Shaw. The inning is over, but lo and behold, not before a lot of noise, a lot of music from the Nashville boys.
Well, the offense has certainly woke up. You can see right there, the first of two home runs in this inning. Tennessee making it rain here in Williamsport.
Come on, get open.
The Goodmore is always watching your favorite players with NFL Mobile on Verizon.
Get in there!
Go, 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 yes!
Let's go, Drew.
The not-so-Goodmore would be them always watching you.
Go for it, Paul! Get open!
Come on, Paul! Let's go! Hustle! What is that, chamomile tea? You want to take a nap?
Get the Goodmore with NFL Mobile free with the More Everything plan exclusively from Verizon.
Now get 50% off all new smartphones.
Get a large two-topping pizza for just $7.99 at PizzaHut.com. A deal this good only lives online. So for a limited time, try the $7.99 online deal any day of the week when you order at PizzaHut.com. The best Pizza Hut deals live online. Pizza Hut.
Discover the family film inspired by an incredible true story.
Winning a lot of games is doable. Teaching kids there's more to life, that's hard.
It's triumphant. Much more than football, this is a story about life. Where the game stands tall. Rated PG.
Some people think coaching is all strategy, but every coach knows strategy. You've got to find an edge wherever you can, and this is mine. This Intel-based tablet does anything I need, precisely when I need it. When you've got a whole team depending on your split-second reaction, performance matters. This Intel processor helps win championships.
Jay Harris in the ESPN studios. Gordon Hayward warming up. He played Little League Baseball, as did Steph Curry. They'd be digging this game right now if they weren't busy. USA Brazil already underway on ESPN News. You can see it on ESPN after Tennessee, Rhode Island.
Tennessee's got a 7-5 lead, and now Rhode Island comes to the plate in the bottom of the sixth inning. Even though they gave up five, that's certainly not going to knock Dave Belisle off of his high horse. And here's what he said to motivate his kids.
We got the hammer. We got the home team. We're putting three on the board. Okay, if anybody's not on board, which I doubt very much with this team, okay, that's in the back row. But what I expect is come on, Americans, to fight. They took it to you that inning. Did you like to get pounded that inning?
No,
did you like it? Did you like what they did to CJ?
No, go.
Did you like what they did to CJ?
No, go.
Okay, then what are we going to do to respond?
Hey.
What are we going to do to respond?
Hey.
Now let's go get them. Let's go. On three. One, two, three.
Hey.
Let's go.
Nomar, I am ready to put my uniform back
That's what
on,
I'm
bro.
Saying.
I mean,
let's come out of retirement.
Put me in,
let's
coach.
Go.
Wow. Go, well, Tebow.
That's fantastic.
One of the guys barking was this one, Trey Tebow, who's already homered tonight. First pitch in there, called strike from Tyler Finley. Yeah. Off the glove of the shortstop. Tebow time continues here in Williamsport. 4-for-4 in the World Series.
And I love when the coach was giving him that speech. He was in the back. I mean, he was fired up.
Nice.
And he gets this team going.
Nice flat swing right there. Level swing through the zone. Tebow time.
Yes, sir. Leadoff man on in the sixth. And that means the tying run comes to the plate. Been a night of Trey's. Trey Tebow. He'll have a special pinch runner go in for him, and he'll get a lot of high fives as he heads to his dugout. So Trey Tebow out, Trey Bourque up. Trey Bourque hit a three-run home run. That came in the second. This one into center field. Mears to second, and Rhode Island is fighting back. Back-to-back singles. They're all following the Belisle train right now. Tyler Shaw next up. Bunts, and it's a good one. Runners to second and third. Shaw retired, but the tying run's now on second base.
Very impressive bunt right there. Textbook baseball. Now you got two runners in scoring position with two chances to get them home. Gets that bat out in front, lays it down, makes that first baseman or the pitcher field the ball. Runners advance, Nomar. That is great baseball.
I mean, how can you not get fired up after that speech? They're coming
expected
through for him.
In the infield, all right, let's take the outs. Take the outs, looking back. Getting out, okay? All right, let's go. We're solid right here, all right, baby? You got this, Tyler.
The number nine hitter in the order for Rhode Island is Mason Matos, who has one hit here in Williamsport, and it's a home run. A home run now would win it. Slow breaking ball, ball one. Look at how shallow that outfield is. This one in the dirt, and it'll stay right at home. It looked like it may have bounced off the umpire.
And I think it did, Carl. And fortunate for Tennessee, because Slaughter had no idea where that ball was. It's by him, yep.
It hit the ump, but it may have saved at least one run and another runner from going from second to third. Matos, big rip at it, and he fouls it back. The outfield has moved back to conventional play. Otherwise, we basically had seven infielders. One hitters count for Matos. We get back to the top of the order for Rhode Island after Matos at bat, if necessary. Back up the middle off the glove of the pitcher and into center field. One run comes in, holding at second base wisely. Was Tyler Shaw, and it's a one-run game.
Coming through with a base hit back up the middle, just off the glove of Finley. And for Bork, he's like, I don't know where to go here. I think I'm just going to stay here because I'm still in scoring position.
That's the right decision, yes. Too. If you're not sure, you're on that bag. They cannot tag you out. Good decision by the young man.
And especially with the top of your lineup coming back up in the order, guys that you rely on to score some runs and put the ball in play.
Trey Bork's at second base, the tying run. Nick Croteau pulls it foul. Croteau's hitting 500 at the Little League World Series, and of all the hitters that Dave Belisle has on his team that he probably would want up, this would probably be the number one guy, tough guy to strike out. On the ground to short, fielded there, throw across the diamond high, out at first base, second out of the inning. Dave Belisle, with a challenge left, will at least ask if the foot came down first.
That's definitely worth the challenge, or worth an at. Definitely have to ask to discuss this. I mean, if you have one left, you don't need to hold that one in your pocket.
Absolutely not. See right here, Croteau hitting the ball to the right of the shortstop. Nice play by the shortstop, Drew Byers.
Good call,
yeah.
Too.
Yeah.
Looks like he got down in time.
Cade Reynolds came down with his foot on the base.
I think he did.
That toe landed on the dirt first. That is worth another look, because his foot came down, but was the toe on the dirt, and then did the heel hit after the base runner's foot made contact. I'm not sure.
Yeah, that other angle that we just saw was, this is where you can possibly see if he's not touching it yet.
Ooh,
I don't know.
Whoa.
Or was the front of his foot actually on the corner of the base when he landed?
I don't think it was, but maybe it possibly got down into.
Well, that's just
I don't want to have to call that one. I'm sorry.
It's a huge call because it's either bases loaded and one out, or second and third and two outs. You want an instant replay, boys and girls. You got instant replay. Here's the call. The call stands. Croteau is out. Certainly something else now to keep our eye on with the tying run at third and Trey Bork. Any ball in the dirt that gets by the catcher, Bork likely to take off. And how fitting is it that C.J. DeVoque, who was the pitcher for Rhode Island during that big five-run inning, is now at the plate.
All right, guys, hey, we're one out away, okay? But this is the, hey, one out away, all right, we got two outs, so pop fly, we got to catch it, diving bodies, all right? Base hit, that it's all or nothing at home. Y'all understand that? All or nothing at home, that run is the winning run, we have to throw them out, all right? You catch the ball, it's over two, we win, okay? You understand that? Okay, hey, diving bodies in the infield to keep that run from scoring. If you dive, knock it down and get it to the plate, okay? Let's go. You got this.
Chicago and Nevada play tomorrow. The loser of that game gets the winner tonight, and that's still very much up in the air with two outs and C.J. Devoc at the plate. Trey Borch at third base, a wild pitch or pass ball could tie the game. Called strike. This ball to left center, it's by the outfielder, and Rhode Island is going to win it on a walk-off hit from C.J. Devoc. Can't believe what happens. Five runs in the top of the sixth and a three-run bottom of the sixth. Cumberland, Rhode Island advances. They are not eliminated. How do you not but tip your hat to the kids from Nashville who fought back?
Seesaw battle, but I tell you what, you talk about leadership, Belial staying so positive, although things look so bad for this team from Rhode Island. What resilience, but that starts with leadership. That's all about attitude. And what a great game we just witnessed. Back and forth affair, Nomar. And fantastic plays, wow.
And C.J. Devoc coming in and coming up with the big hit after giving up the runs in the last inning, and I think it all has to do with the speech that Belial gave and said, I believe in you, you're gonna come through for us, and look, it gets the breaking ball, head down, staying on it. That was textbook line drive. Well earned, you just won the game there.
And Carl, you mentioned it, he was on the mound when Tennessee mounted that comeback. And then he has to come up with two outs and two runners on and comes up with the double. How about that?
How happy is David Belial for his kids, and how happy are so many people who have watched this game for David Belial? A great effort from Robert Hassel in center field. That says it all, and what this team means to the manager. And you get the sense what now it means to the state of Rhode Island. What a phenomenal game. 8-7 the final score. Rhode Island a winner over Nashville, Tennessee. USA Basketball presented by Nike's coming up next noon. ESPN2, South Korea and Puerto Rico. It's been a privilege and a pleasure for Jamie Sire, Barry Larkin, Nomar Garciaparra, our entire ESPN crew here. I'm Carl Ravitch saying so long from Williamsport. Look forward to seeing you tomorrow.
Welcome everyone to the United Center in Chicago. I'm Mark Jones courtside along with Fran Fraschilla and Bob Holtzman. United States ranked number one in the FIBA World Rankings, taking on the 10th ranked Brazilians. And right now the United States leading 17-12 behind some hot shooting from Steph Curry. Curry with 7 points in the ball game to lead the way. As Anderson Varejão, the Cleveland Cavaliers, checking into the ball game now for Brazil.
Probably the happiest guy in Sao Paulo the day that LeBron James said he was coming home, right?
He called him his favorite teammate. Marcelinho with the pass to Barbosa. Barbosa fouled by Curry. Andrew Barbosa played 20 games this year for the Phoenix Suns. And the United States reconvening for the first time in about 2 weeks since the injury to Paul George, who we hope to speak with a little bit later in the show. And since the departure of Kevin Durant, the reigning MVP in the NBA, citing fatigue, both physical and emotional. Rudy Gay subsequently joining the team. Rudy Gay already having an impact here as James Harden gets set to check back into the ballgame. This team right now about 2 weeks away from its first game, August 30th, against Finland in the inaugural FIBA World Cup. Where do you think it leaves this team in its mood right now?
Well, you know, the simple fact is they're not going to be tested in pool play. They're in the weakest pool of the four pools, 24 teams in the World Championships. What they're doing right now, these exhibition games, these friendlies, is just trying to figure out role delineation, how much guys can play, how good a shape they're in.
Great block by Rudy Gay. He's obviously in good shape. Turnover by Brazil. USA on the run. Thompson on the move. Lobs up Davis with the punch. Oh, he caught a body that time.
Nice find by Klay Thompson. One of those guys that, you know, you hear, you read the blogs, he's going to get cut. You know what? This guy is a defender. He's a scorer. I think he'll be a great teammate, great role player in Spain.
Splitter inside. He's been four so far. This time gets ripped. The United States pushing again. There's Thompson. Oh, man. Oh, man. What a tip by Anthony Davis. The Chicago kid making a homecoming. Having an impact.
Wow. Where do you see this again, Mark?